that hits all three heads of the tricep, depending on when you push. You push forward, or you push behind you, isolates different parts. But on this side, you're gonna go super heavy, about 4 reps or so. Then drop the weight, power down, and then go hit the outer part with the rope in a circuit. So I'm gonna need you to help push this down while I lock my feet in, because I'm going pretty heavy. You know, I'm not even a big guy, and I have to add weight to the whole stack. So that's one of the disadvantages of working out in suburbia. But alright, push it down and let me lock my feet in, okay?
Alright. All right.
Go. Oh, let me lock it in. Okay, I'm good. That's it right there. Oh. After doing a power down set, you gotta go to complete failure on the first set. Knowing that you're gonna power down shouldn't stop you at like 4 if you can go to 5. You should go to complete failure, then power down. And when you power down, what you're pretty much doing is you're prolonging that muscle under tension. So whether you normally stop, that'd be all the stimulation your muscle would get. You keep going with lighter weight, progressive overload. Drop it. I try to aim for dropping about 30, sometimes 40% of the weight each time. And then switching the way the handles are. Like I said, you can push out, push in. Just focus on different parts of the tricep. Pretty low, switch the stance, and just go to failure. Moving on to the rope. Now, these two exercises I usually sometimes do in a circuit fashion like that, but not a power down on every set that I do. But with this, with the rope, focus on going down and twisting out to really emphasize this outer part. Then when you cannot twist out anymore, focus on just pushing down. Because that's easier, but you still go. Well, forgot that I took the clip for the other thing.
Give me the news, I gotta bad case of loving you.
I like to lean forward, feel like I can move more weight. Really squeeze the tricep on the bottom.
Alright, with this exercise, the last exercise for tricep, it's gonna hit this inner part of the tricep, this bulk right here, that. The only way you could do that is by doing this kind of movement over your head. And you could do it sitting down. I like to do it on an incline, that way I can get a deeper stretch in the tricep on the bottom. Then the thing to remember is bringing it up. You want to make sure the weight, when you bring it up, faces the mirror. So you can get a full extension and stretch. Go all the way deep down. Keep your elbows in. And then pointing all the way. So, now if you look in the front of the tricep, you really see that stimulation that I'm talking about. And that really stretches out your serratus too. The tricep finish. One arm at a time. A lot of people don't utilize this machine to its full potential. Like, on chest day, I'll do push-ups with this sometimes as well. But, gotta keep the intensity with the finisher, like back-to-back with exercises.